In this video, we'll demonstrate how to set up and use comments in Dodeca. Let's start out by adding a basic system for viewing and submitting comments to our pre-existing view, My Report. We'll expand on this in a later video tutorial, but for now let's get a basic demonstration of Dodeca's comment system up and running. There are two basic steps involved in adding comments to an SBase Excel view. First, we'll modify our Excel template, adding some comment fields, key value pairs, and a named comments range. Second, we'll configure the view for comments by adding a comments range configuration. For this report, we'll simply add some comment fields to the bottom of the view. In a previous tutorial, we assigned some workbook script functionality to our view. For this tutorial, we'll turn that functionality off by simply opening the view's metadata editor for our view, My Report, and under the Workbook Script Properties category, setting the Workbook Script ID property to the blank entry in the dropdown. Commit the changes, and now when we run our view, we'll see that the Workbook Script assigned to it has been turned off for the time being. Currently, our view looks like this. It has selectors at the top for product, measures, and scenario. What we'll do is add an area at the bottom of the report where end users can view, post, or edit comments for the report, given the current selections for product, measures, and scenario. We'll allow unique comments to be made for each market, East, West, South, and Central. In order to do this, we'll need to modify the Excel template assigned to the view. Open the Binary Artifacts metadata editor and select the template assigned to My Report. You can do this from the Dodeca admin menu, or simply right-click on the view in the Runtime View Selector pane and choose the button labeled Edit Excel Template. From the Binary Artifacts metadata editor, press Export to save a copy of the Excel template to the local file system. We're going to save a copy to the desktop. Note that if you already have a current copy of the template saved on your computer, you can skip this step, but exporting a copy ensures that you're working with the current version of the template. Now open the exported myreport.xlsx in Excel. First, add a label for the comments field. Call it, for example, commentary. Next, we'll copy the labels for each of the four markets and paste them beneath commentary. Finally, we'll create some space for our comments besides each of the market labels. For each of the four rows, I'm going to select the range of cells from column B to column F, and then press the Merge Cells button. Optionally, we'll change the background color of the comments range so that it stands apart from the view's data. Comments in Dodeca rely on a keying structure, which in this case will be a semicolon delimited list of dimension names and values in the form of dimension equals value. So our comments for East will utilize the following key value pairs: market equals East, product equals the value of the product selector represented by t.product, measures equals the value of the measures selector, and scenario equals the value of the scenario selector. In this simple example, our comments will not be tied to the year dimension elements, so we don't need to include them in our list of key value pairs. Typically in Dodeca, we enter the key value pairs into a cell as an Excel formula and then later hide that cell. In the cell to the right of the comments field for East, which in our case is cell G14, type the following formula. equals double quote market equals double quote ampersand A14 ampersand double quote semicolon product equals double quote ampersand $B$4 ampersand double quote semicolon measures equals double quote ampersand $C$4 ampersand double quote semicolon scenario equals double quote ampersand $D$4 ampersand double quote semicolon double quote. In the formula, A14 is a relative cell reference that refers to the comment label East. $B$4 is an absolute cell reference that refers to the value selected for the product dimension. $C$4 refers to the value selected for the measures dimension. And $D$4 refers to the value selected for the scenario dimension. Copy the value of cell G14 and paste it down into the remaining three comment rows. Note that the value for market reflects the comment label for each row. Note that if your report uses aliases, you'll probably still want to use member names in your key value pairs because they're less likely to change in the future. The final change that we need to make before saving our Excel template is to add a named range for our comments field. Select the range of cells from B14 to F17. And then, using the name manager, add a new name called comments.range. As before, make sure that the range is scoped at the sheet level, and then press OK to add the range to the template. Two things to note before we re-import the Excel template into Dodeca. One, you can assign any name you like to the comments range in the new name dialog, but you do need to remember it later when configuring comments in Dodeca. In this tutorial, we used the name comments.range. And two, you'll need to note the location of your key value pairs relative to the named comments range. Our key value pairs are located 5 columns to the right of the comments range, and we'll need to specify this relative location when setting up comments in Dodeca in the next step. Now choose a cell and save the changes to the Excel template. Return to Dodeca, and from the Binary Artifacts metadata editor, create a new version of the My Report binary artifact by pressing the New Version button, and then press Import. Select the MyReport.xlsx template that we just saved, and then press Open. Press Commit, and our new version of My Report will be saved to the database. From the Dodeca admin menu, or by right-clicking My Report in the Runtime View selector and choosing Edit View, open My Report in the View's metadata editor. The first thing we'll do is update the view to use our newly imported version of the My Report binary artifact. To do so, navigate to the Excel Template Properties category, and under the Excel Template binary artifact property, choose My Report version 3, where version 3 corresponds to the version of the Excel template that you just imported. Note that creating and choosing between multiple versions of an Excel template is optional in Dodeca. If you wish, you can simply import and commit the changes to the binary artifact without creating a new version, but you won't be able to revert to a previous version of an Excel template unless you have it saved to your local file system. Now, find the Comments Properties category. In the comments category, we'll start by setting up comment ranges. Click the button to the right of the comment range's property value to open up the comment range configurations editor. Then press Add to create a new comments range configuration. We'll assign a caption to the comment range. This property value is arbitrary, but let's call it commentary as in our Excel template.
Under the Behavior Properties category, set the commit policy to OnCellInput. This ensures that comments are saved in the database as they are typed.
Set the InCellDisplay policy to show most recent. This tells the view to display the most recent comment in the report. Set the edit policy to edit in cell, because at this point we're not going to be using Dodeca's Comment Explorer, and rather we'll be editing comments in the cell. Because we're not using the Comment Explorer yet, we'll set the allow delete string and allow update string properties to true. Note that these values can be set conditionally using Excel formulas and/or Dodeca workbook script notation. Set the thread policy to one comment only. For now, we'll be displaying comments on the worksheet, so let's allow only one comment per field. Next, under the Indicator Properties category, set the Comment Indicator policy to none. Again, because we're not using the Comment Explorer, there's no need to use an Excel comment indicator. Finally, scroll down to the Linking Properties category. These properties tell Dodeca where to find the comments range, as well as where the key value pairs are located on the worksheet. Set the address property to the named range that we created earlier in the Excel template. In this tutorial, we're using the name comments.range. Finally, we need to set up the value of the key item string property so that Dodeca can link the comments range to the key value pairs for the current report. This property value should reflect the key value pairs that we set up earlier in our Excel template, so we'll use a Dodeca function inside of an Excel formula to return the value of the cell 5 columns to the right of the current comment field. Open the key item string editor by pressing the button to the right, and type the following string: equal sign offset open paren at a cell open paren close paren comma 0 comma 5 close paren. Here, using Dodeca functions inside of an Excel formula, we're returning the value of the cell 5 columns to the right of the active cell. In our case, the active comment cell will be in column B, and the cell containing the appropriate key value pairs will be in column G. So we'll use an offset of 0 rows and 5 columns. Press OK to close the editor, and then press OK again to finish the newly created comments range configuration. Let's go ahead and preview the report. Press the preview button to open My Report, and you'll see the newly added comments range. Now enter some text into a comment field. This comment will only be tied to the current selections for this view. So when we change our selections and rebuild the view, We can see that there are no comments entered for this combination of selections. If we go back to our original selections for product, measures, and scenario, our comments will again be displayed in the comments field. Return to the Views metadata editor, and then go ahead and commit the changes to the database by pressing the Commit button.
Now that our comment system is up and running, we can return to the Excel template and hide the column containing our key value pairs from view.
Save the template once again. Re-import it into Dodeca. And congratulations! You now have a basic comment system up and running. In this video tutorial, we created a basic comment system that ties an existing Dodeca view to users' comments stored in the Dodeca database. In the next video, we'll expand our basic comment system, demonstrating threaded comments, user and timestamp information, as well as the Dodeca Comment Explorer.